Armadale Capital, the AIM-quoted investment company focused on natural resources projects in Africa, has told investors about a further significant resource increase and an upgrade in the JORC code-compliant mineral resource estimate classification for the Mpokoto gold project in the Katanga province of the Democratic Republic of Congo. Justin Lewis is the director at Armadale Capital. So Justin, what does this reveal? Does it reveal more upside potential?
Well, we're pleased to announce an upgrade in the resource, about a 34% increase in the overall resource to about 678,000 ounces of contained gold. In addition, we've also announced a significant upgrade in the oxide proportion of about 25%, which is where we're very much focused initially, because that's the cheaper or where it is where we can get lower cost gold from. In terms of further upside potential, CSA, who are the consultants who've helped us put this together, have defined an exploration target of around 2 million tonnes, very close to where the existing resource is. So this upgrade in resource came about from infill drilling. We did a program which was probably about 50% of what we originally planned, and CSA are confident that there is quite a lot of further upside in the very close locality to where the current resource is at the moment.
So how close are you to securing a mining license for the project?
We hope very close, I think is probably the short answer to that. It's obviously something that's not in our control. It's a process that's going through the Congolese government, and we know we're in the very latter stages of that. So we very much hope to be able to say something about that in the very near future.
So how confident are you that you can deliver a low capex, low opex commercial gold mining project in the future?
Well, I think we've become more confident all the time. I mean, part of what this resource upgrade does is and will enable us to, I think, even further lower our OPEX numbers and also lengthen the overall mine life, which in some ways lowers the CAPEX requirement. So the next stage for us is publishing a expanded scoping study, which this expanded resource will go into. And that's something I hope to be in a position to announce the results of before the end of this month. That will, I'm fairly confident, show even further improvement in our proposed operating cost numbers, which are already pretty low at around $650 an ounce. And, you know, we're looking at an overall capex for the project of about $20 million US, which is pretty low. So it is, you know, it remains a project that particularly relevant in these times, but remains very robust at low gold prices.
Now, is the project threatened by Ebola at all?
Not to my knowledge. We're right down in the very south of southwest corner of the Democratic Republic of Congo. So far as I'm aware, the only Ebola that has been in the Congo has been right up in the very north of the country, and you have to remember that the Congo is one of the largest countries in the world. I think it's sort of roughly the size of Western Europe. So there's a very long distance between us and really where Ebola is. And obviously we hope that remains the case, and we hope that it's brought under control as soon as possible. But really, it's not a threat to our operations.
And finally, can investors look forward to further value-enhancing milestones?
Yeah, we very much hope so. I mean, as you've already mentioned, in the immediate short term, we're hoping that we'll have some news on the mining license. We're certainly working very hard at the moment to finalise the expanded scoping study, which, as I say, we're looking to get out before the end of the month. And then we will move on to look at potentially doing a bit more drilling and looking to complete a feasibility study for the beginning of next year, which is the sort of next big milestone.
Justin Lewis, Director at Armadale Capital, thank you very much indeed for joining us.
Thank you for having me.